not the kind of game I play. I'm telling you, baby, you will never find another girl in this heart of mine. In this heart of mine. In my heart of mine. Look into my eyes, don't you see that open mind? Would I lie to you, baby? Would I lie to you?
Oh, yeah.
Don't you know it's true, girl? There's not enough for you. Would I lie to you, baby? Yeah. Would I lie to you, baby? Look into my eyes, don't you see that open mind? Would I lie to you, baby? Would I lie to you?
Oh, yeah.
Don't you know it's true?
Anti-Afro Spengalis, how many times have I stated it? You were going to get the truth here. No lies. And I've made it clear before that you can trust me when it comes to telling the truth. I stated it. I'm repeating it. The pressure is on. The pressure cooker has gone off. See the pressure cooker. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to laugh about that. Because that can be very dangerous. Well, people, guess what? People were throwing water on that lawsuit that the former FDMG abandoned bomb shelter worker had filed. Claimed that Umar owes him, I think it was 3,000. I thought I said 2,000 the last time, but somebody corrected me and said it was $3,000. He claims he was owed $3,000. He filed a lawsuit, and Thank You Resource updated me today that the process is moving forward. This person, by all accounts, is serious. There hasn't been a chance to even sweep the abandoned bomb shelter for undetonated bombs. Not one child has sat in a seat. Yet, there's a lawsuit for a former worker who says he wasn't paid. What does the future hold for this non-existent, never will exist, abandoned bomb shelter perping as a school? And I don't know why I went to the Newcastle website, county website, like Dee Dee has stated from Dee Dee and Paige. I don't even know why you're going over there, because nothing's changed. And she is right. Umar hasn't been paying the bills. Isn't that clear-cut evidence right there? If you haven't paid any of the bills in 2 years, aside from a very small amount in the big scheme of things, how in the world can anybody be convinced in any respect that there was ever any plan to open up any school? There's no justification. So already there are lawsuits. Well, I'm saying plural lawsuits because that's another story. We won't go there at this point. Related to the abandoned bomb shelter. All the people that are getting so excited and upset about Umar going on the Breakfast Con show, that does nothing but help the anti-fraud warrior cause. Because Umar went on the Breakfast Con and had them put up that FDMG non-existent school for donations. That's just playing right into the hands that this is a fraud. That was the worst thing Umar could have done. And I mentioned that, I referenced that earlier. All of this evidence is coming together. Lawsuits. Going on the Breakfast Con, asking for money, surely got a cash infusion, Guaranteed, not a single penny of that cash infusion went to pay any of those bills. Yet he continues to go around saying he's opening a school. What kind of evidence does that support? That supports multiple federal crimes. And for the people who continue to try and insist that Umar is linked up with some sort of, I don't know, system where he's not being held accountable. When was the last time you turned in the drug dealer on the corner selling to children? Unless you have made any steps towards holding Umar accountable, what you say is a joke. As if every criminal that you have seen in your neighborhood has been turned over to authorities or has been placed in a jail cell. Don't be ridiculous. Maybe some people can't help it. But as long as Umar continues to rack up these activities, this is going to be in the favor of the anti-fraud warriors. And how does anyone know the information isn't being gathered right now? You don't know. Just because someone doesn't show up at your house with the SWAT team doesn't mean you're going to avoid getting charged with multiple felonies. This has gone on for more than 10 years. And here we have yet another lawsuit. It's very obvious. He claims he was owed money, this worker. Was he ever going to get this through the community? All those lame excuses people are trying to throw around about an ID, it's irrelevant. If an ID was relevant, what is this case doing in court? Understandably, it hasn't been fully assessed, but it would have been thrown out by now. The lawsuit was allowed to progress to the point where the sheriff is looking to serve Umar with the documents, with court orders telling him he has to appear in court. So there is merit to the allegations. Whether they will be sustained remains to be seen. So poo-poo on those people out there that were saying, you need an ID, you need a contract, you need this. You know, you do not. Undocumented people who are here in this country illegally prevail on labor law filings and breach of contracts, just like this lawsuit states. And they didn't sign a single piece of paper. And that's what people think. Just because you didn't sign a piece of paper, just because you're undocumented, just because someone thinks they're smarter than you, they think they can rip you off. Here's yet another example. Wrong. If you put your case in the lap of the law, you have 100% better chance of recovering rather than sitting on the internet and crying and complaining about it. You'll just be crying and complaining about it. You have zero opportunity to recover. Can anybody tell me, aside from when GoFundMe refunded the money, because that's a GoFundMe, when you have been ripped off by Umar Johnson online and GoFundMe wasn't involved and you got your money back? What is the saying? I'll wait. Umar doesn't give money back. As soon as Umar gets that money, it's gone. It's already gone, people. This is the way to go about getting your rights at least considered. And if somebody out there decides, this is snitching, I wouldn't do that. Okay, you wouldn't do it. That means you are up for being taken advantage of. So why don't you put your name and your phone number out there and let people know you're a sucker for the taking if you are going to be allowing people to take advantage of you and you have no intention of filing any sort of documents with the law or even calling the police. You're out there as easy pickings. I sincerely hope that this lawsuit continues to propel forward, because anti-fraud warriors, we would love to get a judgment on this case. Eventually, people, I knew something like this was going to happen, because this person, I'm sure, knew no matter what was stated, he was never going to get that money. What about all those videos people were saying were being recorded? I better get this or I'm going to do that. That all fell on deaf ears. Umar has no intention of opening a school, just like Umar had no intention of ever paying this person. It's take, 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 and more take. Umar feels he's the only person entitled to take in money, and essentially all of that money is for his own personal benefit. How long do you think Umar will be able to live in the abandoned bomb shelter without being discovered? Will Umar ever be able to go in public without swiveling his head around like Reagan from The Exorcist? I am quite sure the sheriff was out there looking for Umar. Look at the dates of the filing on here, people. He made his bed. Well, maybe there's no place to lie down on the bed because all the junk is there, but it's not our issue. This is a public document anybody can access. We will have to see how it plays out, but for sure, it is moving forward. Take a page out of this book. If you feel that your rights have been violated and you haven't been able to obtain the recourse that you feel you're entitled to, by all means, take the next step, unless you want to kiss off, what is it, $3,000 or $2,000 or $500, whatever it is. In the meantime, people, continue to return for updates, because you know the drill. Buyer beware.